Good morning.
Good morning.
Today we celebrate the 28th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We welcome all, especially those who are visiting. October 26th and 27th, there will be a special collection for the Hurricane Relief Fund. Faith and Assist will begin a grief support group in November. See the bulletin for details. Our basket social is going on all weekend. Be sure to stop in and see our beautiful baskets and prizes for a chance to win. Candy donations are welcome to help support our youth group during our annual trunk retreat next Sunday. Keep an eye out for our famous steak sandwich and pierogi fundraisers in November. A special remembrance is made in this Mass for Roland Hefner. Please stand. Our opening hymn is number 672, O God, our help in ages past, number 672.
Father's forgiveness, for he is full of gentleness and compassion.
Your sin to you in a contrite heart, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men.
always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
At this point, we'd like to call forward all the young children to come in with your catechism for the children's liturgy of the word.
Lord, we ask you to extend your loving care and protection over our children. They are the most precious treasure of our parish. Let your word break forth in their hearts. Let it be sweet sound to their ears and a light to their eyes as we send them forth. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you. to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, indeed the word of God is living and effective, sharper than any two-edged sword, penetrating even between soul and spirit, joints and marrow, and able to discern reflections and thoughts of the heart. No creature is concealed from him, but everything is naked and exposed to the eyes of him, to whom we must render an account. The word of the Lord.
Follow the rules. If we make a misstep, we might go astray. And so with any trip that we have to take, we need directions. Of course, there's the GPS in many cars. Sometimes they don't work. Sometimes they lead us in the wrong direction, as well as other people who might suggest that we go this way or that way. And so there's dangers ahead, possibly. We certainly want to be traveling in the hurricane area where roads were closed. We have to find another way to get home. We know that many people go astray, sad to say. Maybe they're looking for someone or something that's going to make them happy. Happiness carries with it many times a lot of work. And many times we make the wrong decisions in life, and we have to live with the consequences. Sad to say. But thank God, in many cases, those who go astray eventually find their way home. But to find your way home, you need a guide. And the guide, above all, is going to be the Lord. He is the one who accepts us as we are. He certainly doesn't say anything about race or social status, education. Doesn't care what you're wearing. We're all his children. And what's this? To be with the one big happy family in heaven. So decisions have to be made. Are we after something? Are we looking for wealth? Are we looking for good health? Are we looking for peace? We could be looking for a lot of good things. And we're looking for good people. Not only to be in our family, in our circle of friends, but we're looking for people who are going to care for us and offer us support, compassion, forgiveness. Life is really short when you think of it. We read the obituaries of people who live long, long lives. That's not saying that their lives were not filled with sadness and sorrow and worry. We know that the elderly have carried with them many health problems. And it's hard to mend fences. But as long as we are faithful to the Lord, we can expect a reward. A reward far beyond our wildest imaginations. Here on earth, we know that the journey means picking up the cross and following Jesus. And God knows we don't like crosses. Crosses carry with them sorrow, regret, and a whole lot of negatives. But we can reach our destination again by following the rules, the commandments, and doing what the Lord expects of us. We too will enter the kingdom of God. So be good, help others to be good, and together you'll be happy in heaven.
Father Almighty,
Creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible,
I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God,
down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, who was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us offer our prayers to our Father, the giver of every good thing.
At the example of Jesus, may continue to inspire all the church in humble service of love for God's people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Spirit of God may work through all elected and appointed officials to create a more just society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That emergency responders and helpers persevere in performing their life-saving duties to bring comfort and strength to the many suffering from the latest hurricanes. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who struggle with disability or physical hardship may have the blessing of God's strength in their daily lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in the Middle East, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the truth, beauty, and goodness of our faith may always enliven our hearts and our spirits. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died in the light of Christ may soon see him face to face. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, in your goodness, hear the prayers we offer and answer them according to your will. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, that through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, a work of human hands, who will become our spiritual fruit.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, Lord. And may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, Lord, from my iniquity. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so with all the angels we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we faith.
intercession, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, pray throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and our fellow bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, all we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may Mary to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Yeah.
May this mingling of the body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to receive it.
Soul shall be healed.
Christ.
Over and see what you can find.
Let us pray. We entreat your majesty, most humble Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Saint
Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our recessional hymn is number 576. O bless the Lord, my soul, number 576.